A weather alert day for people living in and visiting the Sierra. A viewer took this video for us, showing us the conditions in Tahoe City this morning. You can see the snow piling up fast as it falls, the wind even blowing it off that hill there. Roads, of course, completely covered in snow as that snow just blows on by. Ski resorts are also closed right now. Palisades Tahoe posted this video showing why their lifts are not open. And it's pretty clear, right? Officials say wind and visibility play a huge role in determining if they will open. That wind is just whipping up there. You can see their crews trying to plow through the heavy snow. But even with lights and bright backpacks, it is just total whiteout conditions. That is an awesome video. As the storm continues, we are bringing you live team coverage tonight. KCRA3's Catalina Estrada is on I-80 where there are road closures. But first, we want to go right to meteorologist Dirk Van Oren. Dirk, the snow is still coming down heavy, right?
Yeah, it's been interesting to see because we've just had some scattered showers here in the valley. Occasionally, we have a good little downpour, but again, more widespread scattered. While in the Sierra, it's been coming down a little bit more steady. And you can see it's been coming down at a pretty good rate across the Sierra where we just have these big gaps in the rain in through the valleys, not so much in the mountains. Let's go ahead and start with the snow, taking a look at snow elevations. Actually, it went up above 2,500 feet earlier today, and now it looks like they're starting to drop back down again below Colfax level, about 2,400 feet. Grass Valley, get between 2,100, 2,200 feet or so. And we can see that we are still seeing some snow. Not a lot of the snow at these elevations is going to stick, but we do have those flakes falling currently. Now, up the road, this is where it's been piling up, is over Donner Summit, and you can see it's coming down at a pretty good rate right now. This is what it looks like. Caltrans cam on Donner Summit. You can't see anything with the snow coming down and the wind still gusting over 30 miles per hour. Earlier, you could still see some tracks in the road, but right now can't see anything. So visibility greatly reduced, and that's a big problem. And that's why I-80 has been closed because of all the spinouts that they've been having and just the treacherous conditions that they have up over I-80 over Donner Summit. Another spot I wanted to show you here, Placerville, kind of right there where we have the rain snow mix taking place as you go up the hill past Camino and on towards Pollock Pines. That's where it's been sticking a little bit better, but the roads still just looking wet. It's not sticking so much on the roads, doing a pretty good job right now of keeping things clear. It's just not coming down as heavy there, and so we're not seeing that. Wind gusts, another feature. We're looking at wind gusts of 23 in Auburn, 21 at Lake Tahoe, and 20 mile an hour wind gusts currently in Modesto. We're going to take a closer look at the rain and how much we've had over the past 48 hours coming up. Now back over to you.
Excited for that, Dirk. Thank you. Let's get back now to what Dirk was just talking about on I-80. KCR3's got Catalina Estrada is live near I-80 in Colfax, where, yes, the interstate is closed starting there. Catalina, what are you seeing so far at this point? Is it raining where you are?
Yes, Brittany. So we're seeing a little bit of rain. Conditions aren't as bad here in Colfax, but we do know, and you guys just saw on what Dirk showed you, that there's areas like Kings Beach and North Star with zero visibility for drivers. That's why I-80 is closed. And take a look right here. You can see drivers having to turn around and go back down I-80 because they're just not letting anyone through right now. Caltrans workers are here. It doesn't matter if you have chains or not. They're waiting for those conditions to get better to let drivers go through. A lot of people that we've seen come up have turned around and said they weren't expecting not to be let through. Right now, Caltrans says there's no estimate time as to when they will reopen the road. So just a lot of people that were hoping to head up to the Sierra and now are having to turn around just because those conditions have been so bad. Like you guys mentioned, the high winds, the snow, and also that low visibility that just makes it impossible to go up to the Sierra. We're going to stay here and continue to track these conditions to see if they get worse or if they get better, and let you know if they end up reopening I-80. But for now, it's closed here at Colfax all the way to the Nevada state line. Live in Colfax, Carolina Estrada, KCRA 3 News.
So really no getting in or out of the Sierra at this time, at least if you're taking I-80. Carolina, thank you so much. Let's take you now to Highway 50. So this is a live look right now at Ski Run. Yeah, there are some cars on the road, looks like at this intersection here, but you can't really see the road. There is so much snow on the road. The snow is coming down really, really good here. Oh, you can see that snowplow is coming through right now. We know Caltrans and some local county and city crews have been really hard at work keeping the road safe. But again, I-80 closed. Highway 50 still open, but chain controls are in effect. State Road 88 is also seeing some weather impacts right now. CHP Amador posted this picture. Closures are in place eastbound at Peddler Vista and westbound at the State Road 88-89 Pickett's Junction. You can see why the road is completely covered in snow. In fact, that road closure sign has some snow covering it too. While people in the Sierra are seeing heavy rain and snow, other communities are seeing different weather elements. Great sound, right? Hail was falling in El Dorado Hills this afternoon. Ice pebbles were just hitting the road there. Really, really cool shot. You can just see how large those are as compared to the bright green of the grass there. Rain is also falling in parts of the valley. So let's take you live outside with looks across the area. Sacramento on the top left. You have Stockton, Fairfield, and Rancho Cordova on the bottom right. There is rain in some areas. Fairfield, it looks like we have a water droplet on the camera, but in other areas, lots of dark clouds. Meteorologist Dirk Verdorn is going to join us again. Dirk, where are we watching that heavier rain right now?
Well, we're seeing some develop right now, but I really like the way you described it, ice pebbles.
I've never heard that before.
I like that. Ice pebbles. We had ice pebbles falling out of the sky. But yes, we are looking at some heavier rain developing in through the Sacramento Valley now and through Colusa County and on into Yolo counties is where we're seeing that. But let's start near Stockton and Modesto, where we were seeing just some lighter showers that have been popping up. You can see it gets a little bit more widespread as you make your way just to the east of Modesto towards Waterford, Oakdale, Farmington, heading up the hill towards Copperopolis, San Andreas, and Sonora. You're going to be getting some of that rain, but it's a little bit just lighter. Where we are seeing a nice little break now is across Sacramento and Elk Grove, but you move a little bit farther north, and this is where things get much heavier with the rain along I-5. You can see that as you can move up from Woodland towards Arbuckle and Williams, Colusa. It's heading your way. You already had a brief shower, but there's some heavier rain. Looks like that could last a little bit longer, so that's where we could see a little bit greater accumulation. But speaking of accumulation, here's your 48-hour totals. Look at these numbers ranging in the valley, anywhere from 4,400s in Yuba City up to 7,800s in Sacramento, 7,600s in Oroville. But then you get into the hills and look at these numbers. Over 2 inches in Auburn, over 3.5 in Placerville, 3.75 in Arnold, Sonora. Look at that, 2.39 inches in Blue Canyon, almost four inches of rain, at least melted snow, the liquid precipitation. So that would translate into at least possibly up to 4 feet of snow with all of that water coming down at that elevation. So that's what's going on as far as our rainfall. We'll take a look at how long this pattern's going to last coming up now. Back over to you.
Dirk, exactly what you're talking about is right behind me. I can see a great little raindrop right there. Let's go to KCRE3's Orko Mana, who is tracking the rain in Sacramento. Orko, that's downtown Sacramento behind me. Some pretty good rain there. Where are you exactly right now in the city?
Yeah, Brittany, we've been seeing the rain come in waves all day today. Right now here in Midtown Sacramento at J and 23rd Streets, not much is happening. It's just a couple sprinkles here and there, but just half an hour ago, we did see the rain come down pretty hard. You can see some of the remnants of that on our back windshield here. And earlier, we did see people walk across the streets of Midtown carrying umbrellas. We have video of that for you right now. You can see people carrying umbrellas trying to deal with the wet weather that they're seeing in Sacramento right now. And we also know that there were quite a few people milling around. The rain that is falling is visible on the windshields as we were showing you earlier, but we haven't noticed any spots on the ground yet where the water is pooling. Still, if you're driving, just take it slow because you never know, the conditions can change and roads can get slick. Back out here live again, you are looking at a couple of the raindrops that we have seen left over from that heavier rain that we saw a little bit earlier. We are expecting the rain to continue throughout the night tonight, and we of course will be outside tracking those conditions for you. But for now, reporting live in Midtown Sacramento, Orko Mana, KCRA 3 News. Brittany, back to you.
All right, Orko, thank you so much. We do want to see your view of the snow, the rain, maybe the hail. Make sure to share your pictures with us on KCRA.com or on the KCRA 3 app. Just click the upload tab. We would also love to get snow reports from those of you who are in the Sierra expecting some snow. How much snow have you seen fall at your house? Maybe your business. Send those descriptions in for us with your pictures.